It was a rocky start to the new GOP-led Congress. House Republicans, in a surprise move, voting behind closed doors Monday night to gut an ethics watchdog created nearly a decade ago in the aftermath of the Jack Abramoff lobbying scandal. The proposal, offered by Congressman Bob Goodlatte, would have given the very House members who the Office of Congressional Ethics might investigate control over the Office of Congressional Ethics. It prompted pushback from President-elect Donald Trump and even some fellow House Republicans.
This was the wrong message to send at the start of the session, and I really agree with that.
I mean, optically, how concerned are you about the way this makes the Republican Congress look as the Congress?
You know, very concerned. I think it's a terrible mistake.
But critics argued the ethics panel has overreached in its pursuit of headlines and needed to be reined in.
I support it just because I think it's, first of all, I think it's duplicative, but at the very least, in my view, it requires greater oversight than it has.
The proposal prompting outrage across the political spectrum, from government watchdog groups, Democrats, and even Trump, who tweeted, "With all that Congress has to work on, do they really have to make the weakening of the independent ethics watchdog, as unfair as it may be, their number one act and priority? Hashtag drain the swamp." Under pressure after Trump's tweet, House Speaker Paul Ryan, who had opposed the weakening of the watchdog, convening an emergency meeting where the GOP reversed course and unanimously agreed to keep the office intact. Yet the proposal put Republicans in an awkward spot, with some refusing to say if they wanted to weaken the panel.
Did you vote for that?
That was a voice vote. It was not a recorded vote. Quite frankly, I sat there and observed.
So did you abstain from this vote, or did you take a position? What was your position?
It was clear that it was going to pass. So there was a lot of discussion about it, and so it passed. Mm-hmm. That's the main thing.
Did you support it?
You know, good morning. You know, I've not been a victim of the OCE. So there was a lot of discussion about the lack of due process, the lack of transparency. So, again, both good arguments.